Good evening. You're watching Hot Commodities right here on ET Now. I'm Ajay Sharma. Let's take a look at the headlines. The Indian rupee mirrors domestic cues, had a dull day of trade. The currency also hit a fresh two-week low during intraday trade on back of weakness across Asian currencies and a strengthening dollar. The rupee finally ended the day flat at 66.39 to the dollar. Crude oil prices crack in trade. Both Brent and the NYMEX is down over a percent after forecast predict the cold spell in Europe and US could be short-lived, indicating low demand levels in the midst of the global oil glut. Gold prices, meanwhile, slip in trade, trading below the $1,070 an ounce mark. A firm dollar, along with expectations for further Fed rate hike, is also weighing on the bullion. Remember, precious metal is on track to end the year lower for a third straight year. But the focus is on the rupee, which is mirroring domestic cues. It has actually ended flat today, 66.39 is the final tally. During the day also, it went as low as 66.40, but finally recovered just mildly. But net-net, it will go down as a dull day. Let's talk about possible trading ideas and what could be the near-term direction of the rupee and what are the factors at play, with an expert joining us on the show, Abhishek Goenka. Founder and CEO of IFA Global is on the show with us. Abhishek, good evening. Thanks a lot for your time. Tell us, near term, what levels to watch out for looking at the way trade has panned out in today's session?
I think if you look at the rupee, I think it went all the way towards 67 and now it's been getting down because we didn't see much action happening on the Fed. So we are expecting further correction in the rupee. Possibly we could see a dip below 66 for a short brief time. Post that, again, the market could again inch towards 66.5, 67 or plus levels. But for a very short term, possibly in January, we are looking at a little stronger rupee below 66 levels.
Abhishek, there is a sense in the market that, right now the volumes are on the lighter side because participation is low. What is your sense on participation side?
No, of course, the participation is low. I mean, there's hardly any movement in the market, you know. You could see a movement of 3, 4, 5 paisa in the market. Most of the people like us are in holidays. So, you know, there is hardly any movement in the market. So, participation is less from international markets also. The currencies are not moving much. So, participation in the futures and the forwards are more or less. And I think in January, possibly, we'll start seeing some action positively on a weaker dollar side and a stronger rupee side. That's the expectation. And historically also, if you look at months of December and January, typically has been months where the rupee has appreciated. And it's a common phenomenon to know that in December, ideal rupee should depreciate because people go for holidays. But actually, the rupee depreciates in November and gets strong in December and January. And that has been an 80% number historically if you compare the numbers of the last 10 years.
But if one were to look at the yearly chart for the rupee-dollar pair, 5.5% is the kind of depreciation it has seen this year. And that has been pretty much the average, 5% depreciation each year for the last 20 years. Going into the new year, when FIIs, come back, what would your direction be for trade and what levels would you watch out for a guy perhaps who want to take a little more directional kind of a bet, not on a very intraday basis?
So I think the direction of the US dollar is very clear. The dollar is a stronger currency. And as you said, historically, we have seen that kind of a movement happening, you know. 5.5% is a historical weakness in the rupee, and it's likely to continue that way. And the fundamentals are also supporting. The interest rate differential between the India and US is going to come down. The forward premiums are going to come down. So if you have to look at a range, I would give it a range of around 65.5 to around 69. That should be the range till next Diwali that our research says. And if I have to take positions and build up positions from a strategic angle, then I would be buy on dips on the US dollar. Any levels below 66, we would be buyers and we would be covering our position for imports, etc. And levels close to 67.5, 68 are good levels to start booking your export positions or start building some short positions in the market. But probably buy on dips is the strategy if we have to take a strategic call on the currency.
Abhishek, what's your take? One Fed rate hike is already done. It was perhaps market was pretty much prepared for it. But what about the next one? Do you think the first 3 months of the new calendar perhaps may see another small hike coming in from Fed?
That's anybody's guess, but we have we are identifying 3 to 4 hikes next year, and that's again a reason why the emerging market currencies should not be doing very, very well. I mean, the risk on sentiment, which happens on and off, because of which the emerging market currencies like India extremely performs well, you know. So if this year, if you look at India, has gone around 4.5-5% weak as compared to other currencies, it's fairly doing good. But next year, I personally feel that if 65.5 is kind of base, then from there, I think 6-7% weakness is possible in the market. And 68.5, 69 by next year, and I think it's quite plausible. So rate hikes 3-4, currency should depreciate by around 5-6% or 6-7% like.
Abhishek, have you been reading the way dollar index has been moving ever since there has been the rate hike from US Fed? It seemed to have topped out. Do you think during the next couple of months, there are chances it may go beyond 100 or 99? Or do you think it will continue to range in this kind of a range around 98? And what reason would you assign for the, you know, the strength suddenly missing as far as the dollar index goes?
So I think before the Fed hike, the people had built up a lot of sentiment, because of which the euro, the pound and the various currencies had been battered. Post the news, I think the market got some relief. But my understanding on FX is simple. You know, there's an interest rate differentials which will prevail. Now, if euro is printing money, pound sterling is not going to increase interest rates. Japan is in status quo.
Right. We'll try and get Abhishek back in a moment. But let's also tell you how the year gone by has been for the rupee dollar pair. Abhishek, of course, is of the belief that the market could be taking in. Okay, we have the line back with him. Abhishek, before we thank you, I just wanted to also get your thoughts on the euro, because you were talking about how, you know, the authorities there are talking about perhaps some more stimulus assuring the market, but more they make this kind of commentary, the market goes more nervous that how bad is the situation really on ground. But what are your thoughts on the euro?
So euro, I think it's again going back towards a 105, and I'll not be surprised if it goes below that also, because the interest rate differentials are ultimately going to increase. US is increasing interest rates, and the European guys are printing, and they will keep printing, because we don't see any sign where they should be looking at stopping their printing or, you know, increasing interest rates, which is like a way too far. And the US is anyways poised to increase 3-4 hikes. So by all means, I think the euro should go down. Time and again, we will see retracements towards 110, 111, 112. But I think slowly and steadily, we're going to see levels, at least 5 big figures down from the current levels. That is my expectation for the next 6 months for the euro. So it's a clear sell on rallies. That's the strategy for the euro.
All right, Abhishek, we'll let you go on that one. Thanks so much for taking time out for us and chatting up with us. Let's take a short break on that note. On the other side of the break, we'll talk about some trading strategies on the energy side. Crude oil price fall has resumed. Today is turning out to be another weak day for Brent and the NYMEX, which are lower by 1%. We'll discuss all of that when we return.